السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My brothers, my sisters, Islam is a religion that teaches to be fair even with the one you dislike or with your enemy. So if you dislike someone or if a person is at war with you, you need to ensure that you follow what the Quran says, that your dislike, your hate, for example, the war that is going on, for example, should not lead you to be unjust or unfair with that particular person or with those people. At times, humankind is such that they forget. They need to stand firm for justice. For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah is going to hold us accountable for our deeds, for whatever we say. And at the same time, do not let your emotions overtake you. Do not let your inner feelings overtake you. Learn to be fair and balanced all the time. Yes, if someone is wrong, they are wrong. They are wrong on that particular point, but they might be right on another 2, 3, 4, 5 or 20 or more points. So sometimes we as humankind need a reminder. And this is why the Quran has in it verses that remind us to be just and fair. Allah says in the Quran, وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا اِعْدِلُوا هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَىٰ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Don't let your dislike, shana'an, meaning your hatred or your dislike for a people, lead you to be unjust towards them. Be just, it is nearer to righteousness. Notice Allah does not say it is righteousness, because righteousness is so many things put together. Our struggle is to be righteous, to develop piety and taqwa throughout our lives. One of the things is be fair, be just. Don't transgress. Allah says, اِعْدِلُوا هُوَ أَقْرَبُ لِلتَّقْوَىٰ. Be fair and just. It is closer to righteousness. وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهَ. And be conscious of Allah. You are going to go back to Allah. You are going to answer Allah. إِنَّ اللَّهَ خَبِيرٌ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ. Allah knows what you are doing. Now, if you look at the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, from the very beginning, he had people who belied him, meaning they said what you are saying is not true. That is one thing. Those who disagree respectfully is one thing. At least they are respectful in their disagreement. But then you had others who swore him, they mocked at him and his companions, they became physical, they lied about them, they said everything about the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, in order to distract people from the message of Islam. So they said this man is after money, they said this man is after power and leadership, they said this man is after women, they said this man is after whatever else. They raised so many points, and this is why the leaders of Quraysh went to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and they told him, what is it you want? We will give you. You know, they say in a corrupt nation, there is a price tag for everything. So they thought that Muhammad, peace be upon him, would probably agree. You want to be our leader? We make you our leader. You can be the chief here. You want money? We will make you the wealthiest from amongst us. You want women? We will get you married to whom you want, how many you want, how you want, whatever. He waited for them to finish their statement. Then he said, Wallahi, if you put the sun in my right hand, meaning you give me everything, and the moon in my left hand, you've given me whatever there can be to give, and you ask me to stop what I'm saying, calling towards Allah, I'm not going to stop. So they began to accuse him of being a magician. Do you know why? When people listened to his message, they started accepting his message. Common logic, sense, they turned to Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. So what happened? In that particular case, people hated on him. People accused him. They said whatever there was to say. I believe that all those who are doing the work of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, at some point during their work, they will be accused, they will be mocked at, they will be, so many things will be said to them only for Allah to test them. What are you going to do? Are you going to keep going, do your work, or are you going to give up? Or are you going to turn towards or away from Allah or towards Allah? May Allah Almighty grant all of us steadfastness. My brothers, my sisters, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, did not swear back. Why? Because it's not just to do something wrong. May Allah Almighty grant us ease. Although the Quran says, فَمَنْ اِعْتَدَى عَلَيْكُمْ فَاَعْتَدُوا عَلَيْهِ بِمِثْلِ مَا اَعْتَدَى عَلَيْكُمْ وَاتَّقُوا اللَّهِ. If someone has harmed you, you can harm them back, but fear Allah. It is better for you to forgo. It is lofty. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says, I was sent as a mercy. Allah says, you, O Muhammad, were sent as a mercy to everyone and everything. So do you think the one who was sent as a mercy to everyone and everything is going to retaliate in a way that creates a bigger disaster? What is the aim? The aim is, I want to go to paradise, and in the meantime, I want everyone else to also go to paradise. That's the aim. So if someone doesn't like you or says something bad about you or accuses you or has been at war with you, inside you should want that they come towards goodness. That is a true believer. Inside you should ask Allah, oh Allah, bring them to Islam. Bring them to goodness. Bring them to justice. Soften their hearts towards what is right. Soften their hearts towards what is going to please you. That is a dua of a believer. That is a true believer. You are cleaning your heart because the aim is for you to go to Jannah. Through your prayer, if someone else has turned towards Allah, do you know you get a full reward for all the good that they will do? That's why if someone entered the fold of Islam, through your effort, you have a reward for every act of worship they will ever do from the beginning to the end. And you will not be sinful for the sins they do because you did not teach them that. So this is the effort. When Allah Almighty blessed the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, with prophethood, Allah taught him so many things. Allah says there will be people who will say a lot. They will have so much to say. وَلَا تَسْمَعُنَّ مِنَ الَّذِينَ أُوتُوا الْكِتَابَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ وَمِنَ الَّذِينَ أَشْرَكُوا أَذًا كَثِيرًا. Allah says, you will hear a lot of harmful things. In fact, they will try to harm you, and you will hear a lot from who? From the people of the book, people of other faiths, other religions, perhaps the mushrikeen and others, from anyone. You will hear a lot of hurtful things that they will say, not just about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but about you and I, about Islam and about Allah. Allah says, wa in tasbiru wa tattaqu, if you bear sabr, if you are patient and you have taqwa, the consciousness of Allah, that is the best of affairs, the best thing you could do. Why? Because they will realize at some point that what we have done is wrong. Even if it is not today, if it is after 5 years or 10 years or on their deathbed, but they will somehow realize that what we did was wrong. Even if it is on the day of judgment, they will realize what we did was wrong. So be fair, be balanced, be just. I'm not saying if someone has come to war with you, put your hands down and tell them, beat me up. No, if someone wants to beat you up, you have every right to defend yourself and beat them back. Every right, subhanallah. But we are talking generally, you hear people say things, you hear people uttering things. Be just even with your enemies. You dislike someone, it doesn't mean you need to lay a false accusation against them. No, that now is your sin. They committed their sin, now you're doing your sin. But if it is true, no problem, subhanallah. Or if you would like to seek justice, no problem. May Allah Almighty grant us goodness. My brothers, my sisters, take a look at the number of people who they were at the beginning of Islam. Meaning when the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, called the people of Quraysh towards the deen. A handful. The rest of them, what were they doing? Most of them were laughing. They said he's a madman. They said he's this. They were accusing. Like I said, do you know what? Because of the consistency of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, and his love for everyone, and his care that the deen reaches or the religion reaches everyone, and his beautiful character and conduct, one by one they started coming, one by one they started coming, so much so that even those who hated him the most, they came towards the deen of Allah. Those who insulted him, in our terminology, we would say the blasphemous, what happened to them? They turned to Allah. Who do you think Abu Sufyan was? Who do you think Khalid ibn al-Walid ibn al-Mughira was? Who do you think Umar ibn al-Khattab was? Radiyallahu anhum. Today, it is an insult to say their names without saying, may Allah be pleased with them. But where were they? They engaged in that which was more blasphemous than you and I may have seen. Because they were in the presence of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Let alone someone being absent and saying something negative about Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yes, it hurts us, it pains us. But the aim is, I'm going to work with this person. I'm going to engage them, pray for them, so that tomorrow they will become a lover of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And it has happened recently and before. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, for example, you know Khalid ibn al-Walid radiallahu anhu, he killed the Sahaba, let alone blaspheme, he murdered them. They went to war with the Prophet, peace be upon him. But the justice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when this man came across, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to ask his brother about him, where is Khalid? Insha'Allah, he will come. Allah will bring him, subhanallah. In Makkah earlier, the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, says, Allahumma a'izzal Islam bi ahadil umarain. Oh Allah, give strength to Islam by the accepting of Islam of one of these two strong people. Who were they? The worst enemies of Islam. Abu Jahl. Abu Jahl. One of the worst enemies, if not the worst. And the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, making a dua to say, oh Allah, bring him to Islam. Ha. Subhanallah. Look at the justice. لَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُ. Yes, the verse was revealed later, but the lesson that we draw, amazing in the life of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. There is a lot of goodness when you are fair, even with your enemies. Imagine at a time of war, and here you are being very humane about things. Islam is the only faith. The world can tell you what it wants, but Islam has already proven it in its history. May Allah Almighty strengthen us that it has been as humane as it could get. The others pay lip service to it, but on the ground, they do whatever destruction they want. Still on the drawing board, they say, we are this and we are very advanced and we are humane and so on. Go and see the humanity on the ground. Where does it go? Later on, they find out how much of disaster, trauma, whatever else there was, how much of crimes were committed on that ground. May Allah Almighty grant us goodness. So my brothers, my sisters, when you hear things and you develop a dislike against someone, don't let that dislike get to a level where you are unjust and unfair. Do you know, we are taught that when someone comes to you with something and he is your enemy, for example, the person being spoken about is your enemy, you still need to offer that person the right of saying their side of a story, always. So for example, it's wrong for me to pass judgment against someone when I haven't heard what they have to say. That is injustice. Whether that person is your enemy or your friend, you will hear a lot. Today we are living in an age of social media. It has given a platform to anyone and everyone. Many people have accounts that are anonymous because they want to create mischief. And you know what? Good people fall in the trap because there is no one to remind them. Firstly, Allah says, مِنْ حُسْنِ إِسْلَامِ الْمَرْءِ تَرْكُهُ مَا لَا يَعْنِيهِ. A sign of the goodness of your faith and the strength of your iman and Islam is you leave that which doesn't concern you. Does it concern you? No, forget about it. But we love it. We love the gossip. It becomes juicier and juicier, as though you can taste it in your mouth. Subhanallah. Subhanallah. Juicy. You flick and you flick and you continue flicking until you see something. Then you forward it to your friends and you have a good laugh, not realizing what is in it. If there is something unjust, you become one of those who are going to be answerable to Allah for what you did. So remember, in this age of social media, a lot of people have a lot to say about everybody else. So much, whether it's politicians, whether it's religious personnel, whether it's a businessman, whether it's just an ordinary person walking on the street, they have a lot to say. They will label, they will say, they will argue, they will accuse, but they're not leading their own lives. In their own lives, something else is happening altogether. But they are worried about everyone else's life. It's a sign of shaitan. And thereafter, the minute they see something, they immediately begin to believe it without giving the person a chance. Sometimes they don't even know that person. They have no idea who they are. But immediately they are quick to say that, yes, this person is this, this person is that. Look at this and look at that. Do you know what? Here is the verse of the Quran telling you, even if it was your enemy, number one, don't be unjust. Part of injustice is to believe a tale one-sided. May Allah Almighty grant us steadfastness. And today we have so many crises that we are facing across the globe. My brothers, my sisters, there is no solution except for us to become steadfast ourselves, to learn to care for one another. Every life has its value, Muslim or non-Muslim. Every life has its value. For small matters, people are beginning to harm each other, to kill each other, to cause problems. And it starts off with a small spark. You swore someone, they swore you back. Then they swore your mother, you swore their whole family. Then they swore your tribe and you threatened them. Then they threaten you and then one person has to just fulfill the threat. Or a threat got to a third party who loves you so much, they took it in their hands to do it for you. Subhanallah, what happened? This is the end of the world, man. Subhanallah. Where are we? May Allah Almighty grant us all steadfastness. We are living in trying times, tough times. Everyone takes things to heart, takes things personally. No, don't worry. You will be attacked. If you haven't, welcome. It's coming. Subhanallah. You will be said wrong things about. No, if it hasn't come, it's coming. That's why Allah has spoken about it. If there was not going to be this problem in the ummah, you would not find these verses in the Quran. But they are there because Allah wants to prepare you and I to say, you know what? Relax. You need to worry about yourself. You need to be concerned about those around you and those who are dependent on you. And you need to fulfill the rights of all those that you have to fulfill the rights of. But remember, if someone else you have no control over has started saying or doing, do you know what? Protect yourself, defend yourself. Yes. But don't take it too seriously. Life is too short. Before you know it, we're gone back to Allah. How many people have passed on? People spoke about them. They are gone already. And where are they? With Allah. It's too late to say, I'm sorry. It's too late to apologize. My brothers, my sisters, we ask Allah Almighty to grant us steadfastness and goodness. We can change the world by changing ourselves. I know it sounds like mantra, but it's not. It's a verse of the Quran. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ. Allah says Allah will not change a nation until each one changes himself or herself. So there you go. I need to talk to everyone about change, starting with myself. And that change should be positive. Learn to help. Learn to reach out to others. Learn to empower. Learn to say a good word. Learn to make people's day. My brother, mashallah, you're looking good. Alhamdulillah. And the brother starts smiling. What did you do? You made his day. And that's all. They'll go back at least with some sort of a smile. Imagine you're being bashed morning to evening. And in the middle, you come for Salat al-Jumu'ah. And someone says, Assalamu alaikum. So good to see you, my brother. Alhamdulillah, I'm so happy to see you today. Just that much. You go home and you think that my day was a mess. But one brother made me smile. Subhanallah. What is that? The brotherhood of Islam. Greet people. What is Jumu'ah all about? It means gathering. Why do you have to gather? To know one another, to know the difficulties, the problems, the issues. I must help you, you must help me, and so on. Today, why are we failing? It's the other way around. I see you, I start thinking, too much money, huh? And I see someone, you don't know, it's a borrowed vehicle, it's this, brother, you want to live, no one else is allowed to live. See someone say, look at the way he's walking, he's arrogant, this guy, man. Why? What negative thoughts are they? You see someone, what is he doing in the masjid? Did he lose his path here? That's the type of statements people utter sometimes in their minds. Brother, purify your mind and your heart. Look at others, be happy. Be happy they are here. My brother, whoever you are, we love you. You are here in the house of Allah. That's what it is. You are more than welcome. And here we will not doom you and throw you out. We will welcome you and help you in whatever issues you may have. May Allah grant us the ability to do that. That is Islam. That's why we have Jumu'ah and Jama'ah. Imagine if you come for Salatul Jama'ah every day and one day you happen not to be there. People will start asking, where's the brother? What happened? They'll phone you. Are you okay? Is everything okay? Until you might have to turn off your phone because of an irritation. It's a good irritation, isn't it? I'd rather people call me to say, are you okay? You want me to do anything? Is everything fine? That is the deen of Allah. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, has said, and I end on this note. He says, believers are like one body. If an organ from the entire body is in pain, the whole body suffers insomnia and is in pain. Today, when an organ is in pain, you know what we do? Chop it off, out. That's it. May Allah Almighty grant us ease. May Allah forgive us. Really, this is a reminder to myself and to yourselves. And I really ask Allah Almighty to bless every one of us in our own unique ways. Whatever we may be going through, everyone, people are struggling across the globe, different parts of the globe. May Allah help each one of us and grant us ease. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد.